You're doing the prayers. You're doing these. Yes. You're doing this. You're doing the second reading.
Really?
You didn't know?
You didn't show up.
No, he told me that.
You're doing the rest of the second reading.
I don't know what it's about.
So it's a reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. Okay? Why don't you look over it right now?
Matthew,
you got it?
Yeah.
Okay,
wait.
So,
What's this word again?
Thessalonians.
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 Okay, so once you're done, you're going to close the book, you're going to put it here. Now, if Yasmin doesn't remember to put it like this, then you're going to have to change the thing by yourself. Okay, I told her to do it, but I don't know. Okay, so you need to make sure that it says second reading, and then it's the Thessalonians, okay? Since you are taller, you can move the microphone, but just make sure that you're super loud, because you're a little soft-spoken, so just pretend like you're yelling at your mom that you want something, she's all the way down there, okay? So, you can go in the back with the rest of them, okay? Go in the back.
I'll be right there. Stand right here. And then look at Matthew. He's going to let you know when to start. So he's going to look at you. He's going to go like this. And then you say, good morning. My name is Ryder. I am the commentator. And then you start. Okay, so just stand right here.
I read everything from here to here, right?
Yes. Right. Just remember this mass. I'm going to read the 10 a.m. mass. Thank you.
Good morning. I'm Roger Kalinkongan, the commentator. Our readings this Sunday draws our attention to being ready for the Lord's return. The evangelist Matthew reminds us how to be ready by using our gifts and talents, well exemplified by the wise woman in the first reading. As we gather at Mass this day, we are using the gift of the time well. We are making time to be with the Lord, to allow the Lord to speak to us, to nourish us, and to guide us. The presider at this Mass is Father Dan. Please stand and let us begin. Our opening song is number 599. I want to walk as a child of the light, number 599.
We gather in prayer in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. The Lord be with you. And as we sang in the song, shine in my heart, Lord Jesus. So we come and we invite him into our hearts once again. We invite him in word and in sacrament so that he may dwell in our hearts, but also that his light may shine on us. For those sins that have caused us to turn from him and to turn from each other, we begin acknowledging our faults and asking the good Lord for his pardon, mercy, and help. Almighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
We pray. sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us, for you alone are the Holy One. You
Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord our God, that constant gladness of being devoted to you, for it is full and lasting happiness to serve with constancy, the author of all that is good. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
The reading of the Proverbs. When one finds a worthy wife, her value is far beyond pearls. Her husband, entrusting his heart to her, has an unfailing prize. She brings him good and not evil all of the days of her life. She obtains wool and flax and works with loving hands. She puts her hands to the staff and her fingers ply by the spindle. She reaches out her hands to the poor and extends her arms to the needy. Charm is deceptive and beauty is fleeting. The woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. Give her a reward for her labors and let her works praise her at the city gates. Lord, hear our prayer.
Behold, Thus is the man blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion. May you see the prosperity of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Blessed are those who fear the Lord.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. A concerning time and season, brother and sister, you have no need for anything to be written to you, for yourselves know very well that that day of the Lord will come, like a thief at night, when people say peace and security, then sudden disorder comes upon them, like labor pain upon a pregnant woman, and they know no escape. But you, brother and sister, not like in the dark, for that day take over like a thief, for all of the children of light and the children of the day. We are not like at the night of the darkness. Therefore, let us not sleep as the rest do, but let us stay alert and sober. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus told his disciples this parable. A man going on a journey called in his servants and entrusted his possession to them. To one he gave 5 talents, to another 2, to a third 1, to each according to his ability. Then he went away. Immediately, the one who received 5 talents went and traded with them and made another 5. Likewise, the one who received 2 made another 2. But the man who received 1 went off and dug a hole in the ground and buried his master's money. After a long time, the master of those servants came back and settled accounts with them. The one who had received 5 talents came forward bringing the additional 5. He said, "Master, you gave me 5 talents. See, I have made 5 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received 2 talents also came forward and said, "Master, you gave me 2 talents. See, I have made 2 more. His master said to him, "Well done, my good and faithful servant. Since you were faithful in small matters, I will give you great responsibilities. Come, share your master's joy." Then the one who had received the 1 talent came forward and said, "Master, I knew you were a demanding person, harvesting where you did not plant and gathering where you did not scatter. So out of fear, I went off and buried your talent in the ground. Here it is back. His master said to him in reply, you wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I did not plant and gather where I did not scatter. Should you not then have put my money in the bank so that I could have got it back with interest on my return? Now then, take the talent from him and give it to the one with 10. For to everyone who has, more will be given, and he will grow rich. But from the one who has not, even what he has will be taken away. And throw this useless servant into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. The Gospel of the Lord. I'm curious, how many of you would be willing to kiss a frog? How many of you would be willing to kiss a frog? Oh, one person, two, three, four. It's not a dare. It's not a dare. Kissing frogs. I share that because there's an interesting idea in some youth groups. The idea is to kiss frogs. That sounds strange, right? Why would a youth group want to encourage its members to go kiss frogs? But it's actually a noble idea. Now, you all know the fairy tale, right, of the story of this prince, because of a wicked witch, turned a prince into a frog. And so then the only way for the curse to be broken would be if a beautiful princess kissed the frog. And then the spell would be broken and the prince will return back to its normal self. I suspect that all of us have at one point in our lives felt like a frog. We feel cursed. We feel ugly. We feel like a failure. We don't feel love. Right? So haven't you ever felt like you've gotten to that point in your life where you just felt like nothing you do would ever be successful? We've all felt like failures, haven't you? Haven't you felt like a failure? Like a frog? In today's gospel, we hear about the three servants. Two were very successful, right? They were industrious, they were clever, they were able to double their master's money in return. But the third one, you could almost feel sorry for him, right? Because why was he not productive? He explained, he said, I was afraid. I was afraid. Fear. We've all felt fear before. Why are some people more successful than others? Our self-image certainly plays an important part. How would the people see us? There's an interesting experiment that this primary school teacher did with her class. She asked her parents' permission to do it first. And so she asked, after asking the parents, so she did this experiment with her students. So she told them that there's a scientific report that shows students with blue eyes did better at school than students with brown eyes. And so then she had the students make a sign to write down the color of their eyes, and then they were to wear that sign in front of them. At the end of the week, so the students with blue eyes did academically better, measurably better, whereas the students with brown eyes did poorer. So at the end of that week, she of course, at this point, she hasn't told the students the results. But then she told the students, I did a terrible mistake. It's actually the other way around. It's the brown-eyed students that actually are better at school than the blue-eyed students. And as you would guess, at the end of that week, the brown-eyed students did better, and the blue-eyed students did poorer. So what that result of that experiment reveals is that how others think of us affect how we think of ourselves and of our ability to succeed or to fail. So that youth group's idea to kiss frogs actually makes sense, right? It's to encourage each other. We ought to encourage each other. And even though sometimes we're afraid to fail, it's because we don't try because we're afraid to fail, right? Because if we fail, then it really proves that we're worthless. So we're afraid to try. But the truth is, even successful people fail. And when we fail, it's nice to have good people that will encourage us. Don't be afraid. You could do it. Don't be afraid. Try again. So today's gospel can actually be a lesson in not being afraid to fail. Don't be afraid to fail. You know Thomas Edison, right? Thomas Edison. Oh, you're one slide ahead. Are you? What's the next one? What's the one about Thomas Edison? You know how many times Thomas Edison, it took him to invent the light bulb? 10,000 times. And he said, I have not failed 10,000 times. I have found 10,000 ways that it will not work. What a positive way to look at failure. How many of you would try 10,000 times? I think by the third time I would have given up. But to persevere and try again and have a positive attitude. Don't you love that? I've not failed. I just found 10,000 ways that won't work. And imagine if he gave up. We'd all be in darkness, or we'll all be lighting candles. So don't be afraid to fail, right? Each failure is an opportunity for us to learn and to grow. I think of Jesus suffering on the cross. It's almost as if he was kissing the frog in us and saying to each of us, you're worth it. I believe in you. I know you will succeed. Right? He believes in us. He believes that we can do better. And if Jesus believes in you, believe also in yourself. And as that youth group encourages its members to go kiss frogs. So that can be a lesson for all of us. We've all failed. We all could use a little encouragement. So I think it's okay to kiss frogs. So now I ask you again, how many of you are willing to kiss a frog? Right? Because the frog is in each one of us. We all can use a little encouragement. Amen? Don't you like that? You're totally awesome. May I invite you to please stand, and together let us renew our faith in this God who loves the frog in each one of us. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us men and for our salvation. He came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken to the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Loving God, as we remain ever mindful of your gifts, we ask for what we can only receive from you, and so we pray.
For the church that continues to welcome and bless people, especially those living on the margins of social exception, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the world leaders who met in San Francisco this past week, that they promote policies ensuring both economic properties and social equality, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For civilians caught in midst of war and for family members trying to keep peace, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here that on Thanksgiving we count our blessings and in gratitude open our hearts to share with others our abundance, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who are ill, especially Michael and Marie McCrory, that they find strength in God's healing presence, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Charlie Cunningham and Joseph DiMartino, that they enter the glory of the love in heaven, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
This Mass is being offered for the repose of the souls of Michael Moylan and Joseph DiMartino, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, you who are kind to the sinner, hear the prayers of your children, and in your goodness grant our prayers through Christ our Lord.
The song for the preparation of the gifts is number 439. You are near, number 439.
You are near. Stand
And you know when I sit and when I stand, your hand is upon me, protecting me from death, keeping me from harm. Oh Lord, I know you are near, standing always at my side. You guard me. If I climb to the heavens, you are there. If I fly to the sunrise or sail beyond the sea, still I find you there.
Pray then, my sisters and brothers, that your sacrifice and mine may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant, O Lord, we pray, that what we offer in the sight of your majesty may obtain for us the grace of being devoted to you and gain us the prize of everlasting happiness. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For we know it belongs to your boundless glory that you came to the aid of mortal beings with your divinity, and even fashioned for us a remedy out of mortality itself, that the cause of our downfall might become the means of our salvation through Jesus your Son. Through him, the host of angels adores your majesty and rejoices in your presence forever. May our voices, we pray, join with theirs in one chorus of exultant praise as we acclaim.
Hosanna, Hosanna,
You are indeed holy, and to be glorified, O God, who loved the human race, and who always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present in our midst when we are gathered by his love. And when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. Therefore, Father most merciful, we ask that you send forth your Holy Spirit to sanctify these gifts of bread and wine, that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, he took bread and said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, gave you thanks, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until
Therefore, Holy Fathers, we celebrate the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Savior, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand. We proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of blessing. Look with favor on the oblation of your church, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us, and grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. Lord, renew your church, which is in San Francisco, by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis, our Pope, Salvatore, our Bishop, and the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and concord. Remember also our brothers and sisters, Michael Moylan, Joseph DeMartino, Charlie Cunningham, and all who have fallen asleep in the peace of your Christ, and all the dead whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection give them the fullness of life. Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the apostles and martyrs, with St. Anne, St. Joachim, and with all the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen, amen, amen.
At At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer to each other a sign of Christ's peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
The communion song is number 320. I received the living God, number 320.
I received the living God. heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the truth. If you follow close to me, you will know me in your heart, and my word shall make you free. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the life, far from whom no thing can grow, but received this living bread, and my spirit you shall know. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the bread needed long to give you life. You who will partake of me need not ever fear to die. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. Jesus said, I am the way, and my Father longs for you. So I come to bring you home, to be one with him anew. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy. I received the living God, and my heart is full of joy.
Let us pray. We have partaken of the gifts of the sacred mystery, humbly imploring, O Lord, that what your Son commanded us to do in memory of him may bring us growth in charity. Through Christ our Lord. We have a few announcements. Please be seated.
Our second collection this Sunday is for the Campaign for Human Development. This is the U.S. Bishop's Anti-Poverty Program. Its aim is to break the cycle of poverty by supporting self-help groups and empowering low-income people to participate in decisions that affect their lives, families, and communities. Your support is not a handout, but a hand up. Thank you for your generosity. Ushers, you may now take up the collection. This is the last Sunday that we're collecting non-perishable food for St. Anthony's Dining Room, run by Franciscans. This will help families struggling to help make ends meet, especially during the holidays. For all who have donated, thank you for your support. The Thanksgiving Mass on Thursday will be at 8:45 a.m. All are welcome. You can also bring food or drinks to be blessed at the end of Mass.
Thank you. So we do have a Thanksgiving Mass this coming Thursday. It's at 8:45. And so if you want to bring food that you're going to be sharing later in the evening or in the day with the family and friends, you can bring, whether it's bread or wine, you can bring it over and we'll bless it at the end of Mass, okay? We thank our musicians for enriching our worship. We thank our readers today are from the religious education classes. We're grateful that you participated. We're glad that you were here and you did the readings and helping us with the audio and visual, as well as our altar servers and ushers. So thank you all for your ministry. We do have hospitality after Mass, so we invite you to, if you're able to, stay and join us. And if you're new to the parish, or even if you're old time to the parish, seek someone out that you've never met before and introduce yourself to them so that they can feel welcome and we can know other people better. All right? Please stand. And so may the Lord be with you. Oh, I kind of didn't feel it. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace, glorifying the Lord by our lives.
Please join us in our closing song, number 582, Soon and Very Soon, number 582.